it was good to see him again. And he was just kind of in the middle of the card, and he was not a fan favorite at the time. But he said, "The big man done told me," speaking of Bill Watts, "just lay low, kid. I got something ready for you." And we came in, and right before the Christmas break, Junkyard Dog teamed up with Buck Robley, who was a non-traditional fan favorite. And then Junkyard Dog started playing his first theme song, which a lot of people don't know, is Bad, Bad Leroy Brown. And he came out in the wheelbarrow with Buck Robley. You know, we were doing the Freebird thing, and it just took off unbelievably. I've never seen anything to it. But as far as danger, and I think that's what you're alluding to, I've never felt my life more threatened than in that era with Junkyard Dog. And I mean threatened. I mean, we had our car windows bashed. We had, you know, people throwing stuff at us. We had our cars ruined. I remember once we blinded Dog, especially like Charles, Louisiana comes to mind. And we would be coming back from the ring, and people would fill up water pistols full of liquid plumber. And you would fight from the ring to the dressing room. I mean, there was no two ways about it. You were, and it wasn't a question of, were you going to get your ass whooped on the way back to the dressing room? It was how bad, and would you make it to the dressing room? And I remember one time we were fighting out, and somebody shot Buddy in the eyes, and I just saw him grab his eyes, and he goes running for the dressing room. You remember back then we didn't have no barricades, right? Just like a little rope, and he, bless his heart, he clotheslined himself right on that rope. His feet went out. I thought he got sliced with a knife, but it was liquid plumber. Eventually we got it out of there. It got so bad our last time in Lake Charles, Louisiana, the cops would have to bring, and I swear to God, this is the truth, they would have to bring us to the arena. We'd have to park at the sheriff's station and leave our own cars. The first time they did us, they parked outside of the Lake Charles Civic Center, and we walked right in because our dressing room was right there. When they came out, all their tires were flat. So from then on, they'd have to bring the car inside, pull the car adjacent to the door. We'd get in. When the show was over, we'd get back in the car. The last time we were there, people knew we were finishing up because we were starting to be on TBS, they caught a guy in the crowd with a Saturday Night Special and a bullet with undercover cops in the dressing room, I mean, in the bathroom, and it was engraved Freebirds. But that's how much people love this man. When he was blind, and especially down in New Orleans, you know how that would rock every Monday night, they put him in the corner, and he would sit, and each week, Buck Robley would have another black wrestler, you know, come take us on for the titles. And one time it got so bad, Tony Atlas was booked to come off of TBS. Tony Atlas called up and said, "No, it's too hot. I ain't coming." And no show.